These rugged four walls can pretty much take you anywhere. But for now, we're going to explore the colorful streets of Soweto. Let's do this, shall we? Take me away. Ready? 1, 2, 3.
Yeah, so those who haven't explained, right hand, front brakes. Right foot, back brakes. Right thumb, accelerate. When you turn, don't lean over. Use your pedal. I'm a pondo walk. Moving further up, in front of your hand, your right four fingers. Can you see what's happening? There's a lever there. Get your front brakes. So you've got front brakes, you've got back brakes.
As it turns out, Soweto and quad biking make more sense than you would ever think. And following one crazy afternoon whizzing around the township, there is something hilariously quirky and peculiarly South African about quad biking around this densely populated township. In the colorful neighborhoods of Soweto, you'll get an insider's look to life in South Africa's most famous informal settlements, historic sites, and grassy residential verges on quad bikes. And I'm here with the wonderful
Chloe.
Chloe from
Durban.
Durban! How did you find the quad biking experience?
It was fun. I was scared when we went up like a little mini hill.
Yeah.
But it became normal after we did the second time.
If it was a race, do you think you'd win?
No.
Who do you think would win?
This guy!
Yay! There was no bribing, there was no corruption, I promise. Would you do it again?
Yes, I would.
Where would you go? Besides Soweto, if you're given a quad bike and they said you have all the fuel to go to wherever, where would you go?
The Sahara Desert.
Sahara Desert. What would you pack? Five things that you'd pack to the Sahara Desert.
The sand.
The sand?
The more sand.
More sand?
More sand.
More sand. And more sand.
Yes.
Sand is all you need to the Sahara
yes.
Desert, right?
Yes.
And of course, she was able to do it with the amazing Dad!
Away.
So there was no competition between the both of you?
No, I was trying to have a competition with you. I just wanted to go fast.
And then they put me in the back because they're like, you're the fastest, so take the bar behind.
You noticed. Oh.
Introduce yourself to the people.
Okay, my name is Gavin. I was speaking to Chloe, my daughter. First time in Soweto on a quad bike too.
First time?
Yeah. And I'm from South Africa.
South Africa! Which city? Durban?
Durban, that's it.
So clearly we are also supporting the same team as your daughter.
No.
For a Ugandan who would love to travel to South Africa and tour the whole place, what would be your top 5 recommendations?
To come to South Africa.
To come to South Africa.
Cape Town, Durban, Joburg, Soweto, PE friendly city. Is that 4 or 5?
Yeah, 5.
One more.
PE.
PE, okay. And Kango Caves.
hiking okay. caves.
Yeah.
I've been to only two of those three. But we have 4 days here, so maybe I'll visit all the rest.
Quite a distance.
Yeah, I know. Yeah. But we can do it on quad bikes, right?
No.
No.
Maybe. We'll have to check.
We'll have to check. Yeah. What are your favorite things to do in South Africa as a South African?
Well, I mountain bike, even though I'm so big. Yes, I do.
Gotta do some exercise.
Swimming. Okay. Yeah, that's it.
Did you do the bungee jumping?
Not yet. I'm gonna go. I'm a bit scared.
Same. I'm glad I'm not the only one who is actually scared. It's 100 meters, guys. 100 meters.
Yes.
Who does that?
But they say success is on the other side of fear. That's it.
Success.
Quote
yeah.
unquote.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Any last words to any people who are watching at home?
UGANDANS, good people, see you all next time.
Say it in the most South African way possible.
Uganda, come to South Africa.
No, I expected you to say something in Afrikaans or I don't know.
Ek praat nie Afrikaans nie. That's my best of my Afrikaans.
what did that mean? Huh? That you that want me to stay longer in South Africa? No?
Of course, stay longer. Why not? Good
Yay!
Country, South Africa. Yeah.
What was that? Teach me that again so that I can say it.
Which one?
The words that you just said.
Ek praat nie Afrikaans nie.
Ek praat nie Afrikaans nie. So can we say it as a group? I hope I don't get it wrong this time. Okay. 1, 2, 3, go. Ek praat nie Afrikaans nie. The hugely adrenaline-intensive bungee jump from Orlando Towers in Soweto is the first ever bungee jump and swing in the world between two cooling towers, a whopping 100 meters from the ground. A guide will meet you at the harnessing area where you will be strapped into your climbing harness. You will then step into the exhilarating open-air lift that will elevate you up the outside of the concave waist tower to a landing 3 meters from the top. At this point, you proceed on foot up the floating stairway, suspended in mid-air. At the top of the stairway, you will reach the rim of the tower, where you can pause to view the breathtaking panorama over Greater Soweto before proceeding onto the jumping deck. At the jump master's command, you will jump into the fresh air between the two cooling towers, 100 meters above the ground, overlooking the Orlando Dam. So we share a lot in common. Both our names start with S. Shaban, Sarah. We're both from, I was about to say both our countries start with S, but anyway, she's from South Africa, I'm from Uganda. But for now, I'll pretend I'm South African. One other thing in common, we both failed to take on that challenge, so I'm very happy right now. Except she did one thing, she actually went all the way up. And I didn't, for reasons best known to me and my team and the people behind this whole experience. I'm kidding. Sarah, how are you?
I'm good. How are you?
So, you come here super excited to take on the challenge, go all the way up the elevator, and then what happens?
I was fine. I got all the way onto the platform, got strapped up, ready to go. And then got to the end of the platform and realized it was a terrible idea. So I decided against jumping.
Really?
I did.
Who does? Okay, I should not be saying a lot right
now.
I have
no regrets. I have no regrets and my feet are firmly back on the ground and I got back down here in a lift.
Like they say, cowards live longer, right?
It's true. It's
That's so why true. We're going to live 100 years more. So you reached up and you're like, you know what? I'm still too young. I need that paycheck to grow bigger. I need to travel to as many countries as I possibly can.
I've got things to do, places to see. it just didn't feel like the right time to jump off a platform so 100 meters in the air.
What would you tell my camera guy who has the same opinion as you? Anything that they can do to change their minds, no?
You just have to face that fear, and if you're not ready for it, you're not ready for it. So don't do the things that don't make sense.
Whoever is watching at home in Uganda, what would you tell the Ugandan audience?
Come to South Africa. It's a great country.
No, you should say it in the most South African way possible.
I don't know how to say that in South African way.
I don't know.
Okay, I can say it in Afrikaans.
Exactly.
For you. Kom sit Afrika toe, dis die beste.
Kom sit tur Afrika toe, dis beste.
Not bad, not bad. Woo! Take me
away. And with me, someone who actually did it, survived the challenge, and became a heroine. Well, I'm saying too much. The beautiful, Kosi Ogambachi.
Tewale Shaban.
We're taking her to Uganda already. We're taking her to Uganda. Have you done bungee jumping before?
This is my first time, actually.
Get out.
This was my first time.
She's making me look bad.
You should actually look bad, because, I mean, don't use your weight as a game, but, you know. Some of us actually did this, and yeah.
So how was the experience? What went through your mind before you went up there?
Look, once you, when you're on this shaft up,
yeah,
it hits you that there's only one way, like you're going to the top, and then when you get to the top, you have to climb stairs, and the whole process is literally, it's like you're sitting in what is it? A prison, like you're waiting for your sentence, because the closer you get, You can see that, like,
you're counting. I'm about the days, literally.
And then you get to the edge, and before you get to the edge, there's like a platform where you stand on, and it's like all jiggly, and then they clip on the cable, and once that's clipped on,
you know,
there's
it.
Literally no turning sentence. Back, because literally all they say is 3, 2, 1 and
jump.
Yeah, it's gone.
What kind of jump did you go for? Dive.
I'm not gonna dive into my death. No. And then you can't even like pace yourself, because I thought to myself, okay, let me do this, let me do that. Like, you think which way, which one?
All the camera is watching. I need to give them my.
How do you want to look in your coffin? But you're like, actually, I'm dying. I'm in the air. And then
If you had to use 3 words to describe the experience, what would those words be?
Oh, I can't, because this is a family show. To be honest, it is literally, it's amazing. It's exhilarating and amazing, exhilarating and breathtaking.
Breathtaking.
And actually, four, worth it. It's worth it.
So I should just put the mic down and then just get on with
it. Look, just put some sand in your pockets.
So that I weigh heavy.
And then just do it. Just do it.
Awesome.
Just do it.
I'm going to do it.
Once you do it, you can never, like, there's nothing else that I'm afraid of.
Have you done the free fall?
Ah, that's chance play.
Hey! Finally, something she hasn't done before. I did the free fall, so
I was higher than the free fall.
Well, but so, you're seeing where you're going. I didn't see where I was going.
Please look up there. You were not that high.
I literally went
even
all the
way. Even if I saw where I was going, I was not prepared to go where I was going. Like,
okay,
I was just,
she's throwing shade not only to me but to the whole country, Uganda.
No, I'm not doing anything to Ugandans. I'm saying Ugandans should not free fall. You should be man enough, toughen up, and bungee jump.
Okay, this is the part where I walk away.
Yeah.
This is the part where I walk away. Take me away.